This video will explain how to analyze data from triaxial tests using the stress path approach. So in this example that is taken from my book Some Mechanics for Project-Based Learning, we have results from three different tests. So this will be test 1, test 2, test 3. So for each test we had a confining pressure. So that's for test 1 it was 17 kN per square meters. Then we loaded the sample until it failed, and the deviator stress at failure was 140. And at the end of the test, the polar pressure in the sample was 12 kN per square meters. So this is just results of one test. So we need to have at least three tests to get reliable data. And now I'm going to show you how we use a stress path approach to find the friction angle and cohesion for this particular soil. So there was another video that I recorded a few days ago. So in this case, I showed how we can draw more circles for each of the tests, and then we can find a failure envelope, and from the failure envelope, we can obtain friction angle and cohesion. Please watch that video. So this approach, it's a bit different. So we are going to use slightly different parameters, but in the end we're going to arrive again at the friction angle and cohesion. So there are a few steps that we need to follow. So the first step, we need to get this parameter which is called P dash and Q dash. So this is the definition of this. So it's called effective stress approach. We're going to use effective stress path. So in this case, we need to change total stress parameters to effective stress parameters. And you may remember that effective stress parameters, it's total stress minus polar pressure, and the same as for the confining pressure. So it will be sigma 3 minus polar pressure. So I have already prepared the answers. So you will see 75 and 70 for the first test. I'm going to show how I obtain these values, and later on you can practice for test 2 and for test 3, obtain these values 104, 80 and these ones. So let's start with the sigma 1. So we're going to find sigma 1. In this case, sigma 1 is sigma 3, which is confining pressure plus the deviator stress. And then we'll see that for the first test, we have confining pressure was 17, and the deviator stress was 140. So it will give us 157. I'm just going to write kilopascals. So this is sigma 1. Now let's change it to the effective stress conditions. So we're going to subtract polar pressure. So it will be sigma 1 minus polar pressure. It will be 157, and polar pressure is 12. It will be 145 kPa. And then let's do the same thing for the confining pressure, or sigma 3. It's sigma 3 minus polar pressure. And for the first test, the confining pressure was 17. Minus polar pressure 12, it will be 5 kPa. So now let's find this parameter P dash. So it's sigma 1 dash plus sigma 3 dash. So in this case, it's 145 plus 5 divided by 2 is going to give us 75. So this goes this one. And sigma 1 minus sigma 3, so it's the deviator stress. Doesn't matter if we have total stress conditions or effective stress conditions, it's going to be the same. But let's just verify this one. So we'll see Q dash is, it will be 145 minus 5 and divided by 2 will give us 70. Or what you can also do, you just take the deviator stress as this. This one is sigma 1 minus sigma 3. And divide it by 2, you're going to get 70. Okay, so we're going to get these values p dash and q dash for each test, for test 1, test 2, test 3, and then we're going to plot it. So I already plotted it here. So this is value p dash, and this one is value q. And then we have three values. So the first values are 75 and 70. So 75 is somewhere here, and 70 is here. So we have first point here, that's from test 1. From test 2 we have 104 here and 80. So this is point 2 and this is going to be point 3. So what we do next is we will draw a line, best line of best fit, and then see where it crosses Q dash point here. So it will be approximately 45 points. So many students make mistakes. They think that this value 45 is cohesion, but it's not cohesion. So this is what we call M. So remember that it's not cohesion. It's very close in terms of value to cohesion, but we call it M. And this value, it's alpha. So it's not friction angle. So it's not equal to friction angle of soil, but we're going to find this friction angle once we know this value of alpha. So what we need to do, we just need to find tangent alpha, and tangent alpha is going to be equal to sine of friction angle. So I hope you know how to find tangent alpha. If you don't know, you just take this maybe point 1 and point 3. And this is the angle, this is the angle alpha. So it will be this divided by this one, right? Okay, so I already did some calculations and I found that tangent alpha is equal to 0.33. So what we do next is we're going to convert this value of alpha to friction angle. So using this formula, and that's how it goes here. Let's go up. So we'll say that sine of friction angle phi is equal to 0.33. And from here, we're going that friction angle effective conditions is equal 19.3 degrees. And this is the relationship between M that we found here from this graph and cohesion here. So it says the cohesion, it's M, this is M, divided by cosine of the friction angle. And this M we already found from the graph, it's 45. So we're gonna have 45 divided by cosine of 19.3 degrees. And that will give us approximately 47.7 kilonewton per square meters. You will see that value M, it's close to value of the cohesion, but they're not the same. Well, thanks for watching this video. I hope you know how to use effective stress approach. Yeah, have a nice day. Bye.